It's midnight in Broxton, a large council estate 3 miles from Nottingham city centre. Bodycam cops Keith Parks and Paul Creswell make it their business to know what's going on here.
So, in Broxton, I would say I know a lot of the nominals. I like to know who the criminals are in the area because, you know, if crimes do get committed, you can kind of have a rough idea who it is.
They're on high-vis patrol when a car up ahead arouses their suspicions.
I think it speeded up then.
Whoever it was driving realised that the police were interested in them. He just accelerated away and avoided us.
Keith switches on his lights and sirens, but the driver in front has no intention of stopping.
An H, we've got a vehicle failing to stop, I think.
Catching up, they're just in time to see the car disappear.
Hang on, stand by.
But round the corner, it's pulled over. Then, as the cops get out, the driver slams his car into reverse, narrowly missing Keith.
The car came roaring out of the close, and I tried to run after him. Keith actually stopped to let me back in the car, and I shouted, no, no, just go after it, just go after it.
401, it's rammed us. It's going straight over, speed 60.
Paul got a glimpse of the driver and radios through a description.
Driver's a white male, black jumper, smoking a fag.
And Keith thinks he knows who it is that nearly ran him over.
The driver could possibly be. I've not seen him, but he pulled out an address which is well known to him.
It's someone Keith has had dealings with before.
No, it's still going. It's speed 60, clean and written.
The driver is so determined to get away, Keith is struggling to keep up.
Where's it gone?
I got out and so I'm out of the car.
It's a loss.
But all is not lost. A member of the public points to where the car went.
Got in there.
Keith quickly finds it, with its engine still running, but empty.
It's been abandoned. Keys are in it. Is there a dog or anything?
It appears the driver has made his escape over a fence.
I've checked the gardens over here. Someone over there said there was one lad that got out of the car, wouldn't really give much more. So it could be anywhere now.
Keith suspects the car is stolen.
And we're checking how legitimate this vehicle is, because these number plates don't look right to me. But we'll soon see.
An update from the control room confirms the plates are not the ones that belong to the car.
What we have found out now is it's not a stolen car, but it's got false plates on it.
It is a common thing that happens. You know, they try and disguise the identity of it, so they'll find a vehicle of that similar make or model. So if it hits any cameras anywhere, you know, AMPR cameras or even just us checking it, it'll come up as it's got insurance and it's got everything else. You know, and you wouldn't bat an eyelid.
Keith is determined to find the driver who rammed into him.
So he's just going to take the car away, and over the next couple of days, it's going to get forensically examined and hopefully give us a clue as to who's driving it. In the back, what I have seen is a duvet and a pillow with a black jacket, which could be very good forensically, so we'll see. You know, I have been involved in pursuits before, I've been rammed in cars before, but I've always had the protection of a police car. He knows I've got out, because he would have seen me and he's reversed. And if I'd have not been quick enough in my actions to jump in the car, to get away from it, that would have been career-threatening, you know, maybe life-altering or even life-threatening. I've got kids, I've got family at home. I nearly hit myself. And that takes it to a different level for me, you know, it's a bit more personal. Whoever it is, we will find him.
It was then my priority that I needed to find this lad, and I needed to, you know, he was my number one target to make sure that he was arrested and brought to justice for what he did do and what he potentially could have done.
After searching for the man at several addresses, without any luck, Keith has another house on his list to visit, where he thinks his prime suspect could be.
It wasn't a plan to go and just search that address. It was a case of doing, you know, regular drive-bys and just having a quick nosy and see if you could see anyone through the windows.
Driving past the house, Keith thinks he spotted his man.
I bet he's in there. Go and try it. Round back straight away. Round back.
And I was certain that this male was sat there in the window.
Keith's been looking at this house for a while. Today, he could be in luck.
Just go to the front, go to the front.
Excuse me, what are you doing?
You're all right. I'm seeing if he's in.
No, you're not coming in, and I'm not having that.
It's still not known if the suspect is inside, but the woman makes it very clear to the cops that they're not welcome.
So why is your body brand there? Why don't you go find something else to do instead of being outside my ass?
The woman's losing her temper, so Keith's calling for backup.
Me!
Yes, mate. Be as quick as you can.
They probably don't like the police, so let's get as many officers as we can down, because mass is obviously a lot safer.
10-4, you here?
Within minutes, Keith's colleagues Matt and Ian arrive.
I reckon I've just drove past, looked in, where I saw sat on the sofa. I'm adamant, I'm sure it was, because the hair.
Do not open that door!
To avoid anyone escaping, Ian's guarding the front window.
Unless you ain't got a warrant, you're not coming. Why is that little to be here?
I don't know.
Well, there you go. You can stand out here all day, darling, because you're not getting in. Would you like a cup of tea? I'll add spit in that thing, huh?
A very abusive, aggressive female. Got a few more cops here. We'll knock on and see how we've got on.
Yeah,
you'll be able to see the reception committee that's probably waiting for us.
The female in there wasn't happy because it was her house. Negotiations didn't go well. There was a lot of shouting through windows and doors.
And he's in his house. You're not getting in unless you get a warrant.
We don't need one.
More officers arrive with the big red key.
Listen, put that on my door, I dare you! My front door's broke anyway!
She's beginning to realise the cops are coming in, with or without her permission.
Only one of you are coming in, not all of you are coming in,
right, we're not going to let one in, are we?
Listen, you're letting one in!
Right,
get in and move back away! Not all of you!
She's far from welcoming and stepping up the verbal abuse.
Open the door.
He's got men alone. Why are you all in here? There's no need for all of you. You've caused enough aggro outside my...
The search for the wanted man draws a blank, and Keith thinks he knows why.
When we drove past, he's seen us in the window drive past, and he may have thought, that's it, they're coming for me, and I think he's taken that opportunity to get out and run off over the back and gone. So in the seconds where I've stopped and come back, he's gone out the back and he's disappeared.
Word's getting round, I'm looking for him. So it might, again, force his hand to hand himself in.
A few days later, Keith was in for a surprise. With the net closing in, the elusive suspect that Keith had been hunting for turned up at the Bridewell custody suite and handed himself in.
I don't think he wanted to be on the run anymore. I don't think he wanted the chase because we were getting closer and closer and upsetting too many of his friends and family. So he decided that was the time for him to come and hand himself in.
The man, alleged to be the driver of the car that was driven towards the cops, narrowly missing Keith, was charged with dangerous driving and is due to be tried in court.